In every house there is a room, a sanctuary safe and strong, to heal the wounds from lovers' tongues, until a new one comes along. I spoke to you in cautious tones. You answered me with no pretense, and still I feel I said too much. My silence is my self-defense.
But every time I found a road, it seemed I only found the Lord. And so it goes, and so it goes, and so will you soon, I suppose.
But if my silence made you leave, then that would be my worst mistake. So I will share this room with you, and you can make this heart to break.
And this is why my eyes are closed. It's just as well. So it goes, and so it goes, and you're the only one who knows.
So I would choose to be with you, that's if the choice were mine to make. But you can make decisions too.
Hello, Bedales. Welcome to the final assembly of not just the summer term, but the school year, and the most extraordinary end to the most extraordinary year. We have lots of really good stuff to celebrate, and we'll end, of course, with saying a formal farewell to this year's 6-2. It's a great shame, of course, that we can't be doing this in real time in the quad, following our traditions, especially the handshaking and bidding farewell to 6-2, which is a really, really important part, I think, of the school year closure for them as they leave school, and a moment of great celebration for the community as well. So we do keep on saying that we're looking forward to some occasion when things are back to normal, whatever normal is, when we can get this year's 6-2 leavers back and give them a proper farewell, proper sending off in good old-fashioned Bedales traditional way. But if we can't do that, then we'll just do it virtually, and that will come later on in this assembly. So we have lots of awards to celebrate, great achievement over this school year. And I would like to say thank you to all of you who've been involved with the musical and drama and dance collaborations that have continued to go on this summer term, despite the extraordinary restrictions that lockdown has placed on us. The quality of the creative collaboration between students and staff has been absolutely stunning, really, really impressive. And assemblies and jaws have been something that I look forward to, and various musical amuse-bouche that Neil has sent through and Doug has sent through during the course of the week have been really, really brilliant and morally uplifting for me. And thank you, everyone who's been involved with that. So Before we start with our Bedales Awards, the annual awards, the prizes that we give out, we should recognise the achievement of Amos Wallen, Block 5, who's recently won the Under 18 Young Writer on Liberty Award from the Adam Smith Institute. So Amos had to write 3 blog posts in house style on this year's theme of free market environmentalism. Each post had to set out how a liberal policy proposal could improve the environment and show an understanding of the benefits of free markets and individual liberty. So Amos wins £250 prize money and a box of Liberty themed books. As winner, he will also have all 3 of his articles published in the Adam Smith Institute blog. So that's a really, really impressive achievement from Amos. So well done him. So now we move on to our own Bedales Awards. So our guiding awards to recognise 6-2 students who have done an amazing job with their guiding duties throughout the year. And Bedales is, I think, an extraordinary school in the way that current students connect with prospective parents, prospective students, and speak about their experiences at Bedales in a very open and honest and fresh way. So thank you very much to 6-2 who've been involved with the guiding process. But in particular, Phoebe Pepiat, Toby Fairs, Hannah Mazas, Freya Leonard, Anya Gray, George Story, Hannah Dunleavy, who get our gift card to recognise the sterling service they've given through guiding. Then we move on to our Bedales Poet Stone Challenge. This was the student who completed the Poet Stone Challenge the most times during the course of the year. And in the early stages of lockdown, so this is back in Easter holiday, I was up there every day for about 35, 40 days in a row. But then term time intervened and I had slightly less time in the day. But the winner, who's been at the Poet Stone most often, is Theo Heining-Farmelo, who does live at the bottom of the Poet Stone. So it's on his doorstep. It's probably his daily run. But well done, Theo, for winning that. And well done for packing in all the ascents that you've managed to do. Many of you have been busy doing lots of creative stuff during lockdown. We have the Lockdown Creative Writing Project. So a £20 book token for a student who impressed the judges with a descriptive narrative, My Room, in which the reader feels the walls closing in on the narrator. Now, I've been in these walls probably every day since March the 18th, so I can definitely connect with that sense of a room entrapping the individual. But for her piece, My Room, the winner of this creative writing lockdown project is Tashi Feinstein. So well done, Tashi. Then the Cadian Harding Prizes, 2 prizes awarded in memory of Cadian, who died very tragically in 2014. There are 2 prizes. The first is for academic excellence in Block 3 science and maths. The second is for an outstanding Block 3 project in a subject in any area connected with science and technology. So the academic excellence in Block 3. Throughout this year, this student has maintained a constantly high level of interest and ability in sciences that has never failed to impress his teachers. There are many close contenders, but he, the winner, has excelled in maths and all 3 sciences such that when taken overall, he is a worthy winner of the Cadian Prize. A special mention should also go to Catherine Cecil for her excellent performance in STEM subjects. But the winner is Joe Cullen. So well done, Joe. Brilliant. And then for an outstanding Block 3 project in a subject in any area connected with science and technology, the traditional Block 3 projects have not all run to completion this year because of lockdown. And some interesting prospects were cut short very, very sadly. So we don't have 1 single project that wins from Block 3, the Cadian Prize this year. But we do want to give a special mention to Jamie Thorogood for an excellent biology project on wetlands completed during the first half of the summer term. So well done, Jamie. Now we have some drama and dance awards. We begin with an outstanding contribution by a 6-1 student. So this student's contribution continues to grow in her new Don dance role. And she has already been writing for the Saturday Bulletin and promoting the dance workshops we have had on offer during lockdown. She has contributed in many ways to dance. For example, stepped in and learned a 6-2 group choreography just a couple of days before the exam was due without any questions, and shows great willingness to support her peers and her overall commitment to dance. So the dance award goes to Charlotte Land. So well done, Charlotte. For drama, we have an exceptional all-round student of drama in and out of the curriculum. Her contributions this academic year to the departmental offering have been vast and also greatly appreciated. She volunteered herself to assistant direct the whole school show and has done the same thing during lockdown for the lower school production. Assisting both directors with rehearsals and the performance, especially appreciated with the added challenge of virtual delivery. She has auditioned and performed in extracurricular projects, represented the department regularly in her writing and speaking of activities in publications and assemblies. So many films like this through assembly. And so the award goes to Nay Murphy. So well done, Nay. Really, really impressive. Fashion Design Award for an outstanding contribution by a 6-1 student. The Fashion Design Prize this year is awarded to a student who has consistently applied themselves to meeting their potential. A student who looked to maximize the opportunities within set design briefs, and by doing so has developed many sophisticated skills and creative, innovative outcomes throughout the year. This student has become a truly exceptional example to others. So congratulations, Monty De La Guerra. So well done, Monty. The Product Design Award for an outstanding contribution by a 6-1 student. This student has committed herself to the course since the start of the year, consistently developed her skills with motivation and a genuine passion for the subject. She is naturally design aware and keenly observes the world around her. She has a growing sympathy for balancing the essential factors of form, function, detail, and process. It is because of this she has been awarded the Design Product Design Award. So the award winner this year is Jess Sainsbury. So well done, Jess. Now, the Barnsley Scholarship. For the last few years, we selected one workshop-based design A-level student to receive the Barnsley Scholarship. The Edward Barnsley Workshop, based just above the village on the Ashford Hangers, so up there, is a world-renowned workshop. The workshop and its founders are responsible for our library, the Lupton Hall, and much of the furniture within, which, if you saw Ben Shaw's excellent Jaw, which was based on the arts and crafts movement and that told the story of the library, you will be well-versed in the Lupton and its connection with the Barnsley family. The recipient of the award will be monitored through their A-level by the workshop designer, James Ryan, and have an opportunity to gain some work experience there to enhance their skills. This student has grown significantly as a designer and problem solver this year. In her relatively short time with us, she has shown what a receptive growth mindset can achieve, significantly improving her skills and raising her aspirations. Her well-rounded approach lends itself to a holistic understanding of the subject, and thus the capacity to gain the very most from the rare opportunity of working with and learning from James Ryan at the Barnsley Workshop. We look forward to her teaching us a thing or two in the months to come. So the Barnsley Scholarship goes to Isla Payne. So well done, Isla.
Thank you.
Now we come to that section of assembly where we get a chance to say goodbye to departing colleagues. An opportunity to thank them for their service, to point out some of the things that they've done, the contribution they've made to the school community in their time here, and send them on their way. So what we'll do is each head of department or other has made a short film by way of thank you for the person who's leaving in their department or someone who they work closely with. So we'll move through those films next. I'd like to say a few words to thank Louise, who joined Bedales in September 2014 as what was then called the managing head. And she's had a number of different roles since then, all with this massive whole school responsibility and experience. So that remit originally encompassed overseeing the day-to-day running of the school, including all the boarding houses, student behaviour, staffing matters, the tutorial system, the calendar, and that's something that I was in charge of when I was deputy head at Stowe. I made a complete mess of it, so I'm always in awe of anyone, deputy head, who can manage the calendar, logistics, term dates, and all the assessments and registrations. So it is just a massive, massive job. And Louise fulfilled that diverse and really demanding role exceptionally. She also looked after all matters to do with school inspection. And for many years, she was the DSL, designated safeguarding lead. So leading on safeguarding. And so Louise in 2016, then moved to a different role, became senior deputy. So the operational and pastoral, that was the title, but with the same massive remit as the role above. And importantly for me, when I started at Bedales, Louise was always sympathetic and helpful and incredibly supportive and informative in my first year, and really helped me transition from one school to the next, a much larger school, a much more complex school. And much of the smoothness of that transition I owe to Louise. So thank you very much, Louise, for your contribution to the school community over the years that you've worked here. And also particular for personally for the help that you gave me when I started. And we wish you all the best in your new role at Charterhouse. Thank you.
Today we are saying goodbye and a huge thank you to three members of the Learning Support Department. Altogether, they've been here about 41 years. Anna Bingham joined us 3 years ago. At first, Anna was part-time. She worked here 3 days a week and taught 2 days a week at another school. Although it's interesting to hear about how other schools are doing things, it certainly didn't take us long to realise that Anna is a great learning support teacher and a lovely colleague, and we really didn't want her disappearing off anywhere else. So we were really pleased when she decided that Bedales was the place for her and she'd like to continue full-time when the opportunity came up. This year, Anna has been Assistant Head of Learning Support, and as part of that, she has very confidently and competently, and with meticulous attention to detail, taken over the assessment and exam arrangement work for the sixth form, as well as continuing to teach students in all year groups. Anna's husband has a new job at Millfield, so the whole family is relocating during the holidays to Somerset. That's definitely not commuting distance, so I'm sorry we're saying goodbye, but we wish Anna the very best of luck at Millfield.
We are saying goodbye to Melanie. Melanie, who joined us 2 years ago and two terms ago. She came as teacher of Spanish and quickly became head of Spanish. Melanie is off to take a position at Kingston Grammar, which I think she'll be extremely well suited for. Melanie is an extremely versatile teacher. She's obviously taught Spanish, but she has also taught French. And this past year, she stepped in to teach German GCSE as well. An incredibly valuable addition to the department. Melanie has been loved by students who have really enjoyed her style of teaching and her approachable and extremely kind manner. We wish Melanie all the best. We'd also like to say goodbye to Melanka, who has been our French language assistant. She had to go back to Quebec in French-speaking Canada. She was a real character in the department, always keen to decorate our staff office at certain times of year, and with a really warm personality, which I think the students felt in their lessons. She is off to continue studying so that she can be an educator in Quebec. We wish her all the best.
Liz Marriott has been instrumental in building up the psychology department to the really successful department that it is at the moment at Bedales. She's helped develop that A-level into something that so many of you want to go on and study in your sixth form time at Bedales. Liz is one of these teachers who will stop at nothing, really, to make the subject comprehensible, to make it engaging for students. Really enjoy retirement with her husband, Ian, looking after her many grandchildren, and I think experiencing a little bit of the Dolce Vita and fine Italian wines as well. So Liz, very best wishes, and do keep in touch.
Martin Hanak is a Czech midfielder who was worth £90,000 at the height of his career in 2007. Martin Hanak is an Austrian maths teacher who has been absolutely priceless during his 4.5 years as head of maths at Bedales. Martin, who has a master's degree in applied mathematics from Imperial College London, has accused some of you of hiding your light under a bushel, proving himself to be a hypocrite as he quietly went about his business of applying maths to solve problems around the school. He provided you with indisputable proof that vampires do exist. He ordered shelf extensions to stop the books falling off the badly designed shelves in the maths rooms. And most recently, he provided his department with a regression analysis of attainment in maths to predict grades for some of you. Chef Martin has delighted staff and students alike with his culinary expertise, treating his department to home-cooked Thai cuisine and prize-winning students to apple pie, or should that be apple strudel, for Pie Day, just like his mama in Austria still makes, as well as offering cooking as an enrichment activity. No stranger to the bakehouse, but just as happy to don his wellies for a spot of proper outdoor work. He could be as much Andrew Martin as James Martin. You may not have realised, but we passed a milestone in the maths department before lockdown when Martin issued his 1,000th scientific calculator. That means that you should all have at least 2 now, so no excuses upon your return in September. Martin is hardworking. He is a professional. He has an acute attention to detail. He is student-focused, he is fair, and he is a team player. As one of his grateful tutees asked me to say, Martin, thank you for being such an amazing person. We all wish you the very best of luck at RGS, up the road, closer to home and family.
Paul, thank you ever so much for everything you've done for Bedales. In particular, the Duke of Edinburgh Award has seen a huge growth in your time. All those bronze, silver and gold students are very grateful to you, and thank you ever so much for everything that you've done. You've introduced more interesting and adventurous expeditions. So we had a wonderful rowing trip down the River Wye last year, and we were going to go to Scotland a couple of weeks ago if that hadn't had to be cancelled. So thank you ever so much for everything you've done for Duke of Edinburgh Award. Thank you too for everything you've done for Bedales Running. Here I am wearing my Great South Run shirt. You were a great supporter of all our fundraising running events. So thank you too for that. I sit here looking up to the Poet Stone and makes me think of all the runs that you've done, which I've seen on Strava. Thank you too for introducing us all to Strava. And finally, thank you too for your leadership in communicating your subject, geography. Your Geography Paul website is full to the brim with excellent resources. You've been a champion for sustainability and the climate crisis, and you've also led the way in introducing us all to think about how social media can be used to promote and campaign for your interests and passions. So Paul, thank you ever so much from us all at Bedales, and good luck.
Alistair, it goes without saying that we'll all be sad to see you leave Bedales. And it's a real privilege to be able to voice that from the whole school. So from all of us, thank you. You have been a mainstay of academic and intellectual excellence at Bedales, and we will all be the poorer for your loss. You've helped 6 years of students to clear the hurdles posed by Latin and by classical Greek, and you've excelled in that calm support that you've given to so many as day house master. But it's your contribution to the life of the school, to our community, if you like, which goes far further than that, that we are going to miss. Because in ways too numerous to mention, you've added to the richness of the Bedales experience, from a sheer vibrancy for life and a breadth of interests that goes far beyond the purely academic. I'd like to thank you for your support as a colleague, and I'm absolutely certain that the whole school will join me in those thanks for all that you've been and all that you've done at Bedales. We wish you every success in your future ventures. And as the Romans used to say, Arve atque vale, hail and farewell.
Jill Harris is also leaving today, and you'll hear more from Jane and Charlotte in a minute, but I want to add the thank yous of very many Bedalians who have benefited from her expertise as a learning support teacher. Claire Jarmy expressed this recently when she said, one thing that characterises Jill's approach to learning support is that she understands the fact that a student's specific learning needs bear no necessary relationship to their intelligence. She's guided some of our most extraordinary learners through the difficulties of a system not built for the way their minds work. Jill was head of learning support when I joined Bedales, and she was responsible for building the department as it exists today. Jill has taken on other responsibilities since then, but she's continued to teach learning support and to offer the benefit of her experience to me and to the rest of the department, which has been invaluable. Thank you, Jill.
Jill Harris has been at Bedales for 14 years. She moved from Devon in 2006 and moved straight into Steephurst as resident tutor and into the heart of boarding life from day one. Jill has worn many hats during her time at Bedales, but care and support of students is the clear thread which links all of her various roles. She was appointed the position of Head of Learning Support, which, as Ruth has mentioned, went from strength to strength in the 8 years she was at the helm. She was also appointed Head of Block 3, and as such participated in many trips to Ullswater and the battlefields, which afforded her the chance to enjoy the great outdoors, a true passion of hers, as well as interacting with and caring for students outside the classroom and helping these new students to settle into Bedales life. History and PSHE teaching have also taken centre stage, and Jill's passion for these subjects has been clear for all the students she has taught. In 2011, she was appointed day house mistress, forming a very successful partnership with Chris Bott for 3 years. And again, Jill demonstrated her passion for all things pastoral, her love for Bedalians and their development, and an admirable ability to juggle many, many roles at once. She stepped down from her role as Head of Learning Support, and it was no surprise that she became Steephurst Housemistress in 2014, where she has been tirelessly caring and nurturing for girls, past and present, ever since. Before I pass over to Charlotte to talk about her time on Steephurst, I would like to express my personal thanks to Jill for her encouragement to join the Learning Support Department in 2011, and eventually for her support for my own application to join the Steephurst team in 2015, and for being a truly great friend and mentor.
Jill is a house parent with extraordinary skills. She is calm at all times, sees the full picture of care for a student, not just the problem or upset in the moment, and shows endless capacity to give her full attention to everyone she cares for at any time, no matter what else might be going on. Working alongside her, Jane and I have felt keenly a level of support, strength, and firm, unwavering principles that guide all her decision making. She holds dear the principles of mutual respect and cooperative working at the heart of Bedales, and she has worked tirelessly in her time as house parent on Steephurst to help this guide her in shaping the team working together. Jill and I started our partnership 4 years ago, and it was evident from the start that everything she does is guided by the desire for parity of student experience, fairness, and the belief that student voice is of utmost importance. Jane and I are indebted to her in so many ways. We both feel strongly her support and friendship, and care for the many dear colleagues who visit Steephurst and contribute to that. Jill has student care at the heart of all she does, and this extends also to those she works with. She's supported countless colleagues as well as students, and she's always the first to show gratitude and give thanks to others for their efforts and help. Recently, I found myself trying to articulate our partnership and saying that Jill crafts a home from words. And I will feel ever indebted to her for the way she consistently upholds the values of the community in everything she does. Other things we will remember Jill for, or that are little known about her, are things like that she's got A-level music, she plays the trumpet, she's a keen squash player, and her dogs Bella and Molly, who are always on flat and her soothing anti-homesickness tool, and that she's outdoors running or dog walking or hiking up mountains with Steve, her husband, and his students from his school. Jill's moving away to work for the Samaritans and to care also for her mother. And she will be sorely missed at BDAS.
Hi, Lindsay. I don't particularly enjoy doing these farewells. I normally try and hone in on people's areas of weakness and then take the mickey a bit. But I really, really hit blank with you because I couldn't actually think of any weaknesses that you actually have. So I had to think again. And the reason I couldn't think of any weaknesses is because you are, without a doubt, the most professional person that I think I and I think everybody else would agree with me have ever had the pleasure and the fortune to work with throughout their careers. So this is not a goodbye because Bowhunt is only down the road and we will still see you. However, it is a good luck on the next chapter of your career. And Bowhunt's very lucky to be having you work for them, and you will be sorely missed by your colleagues, many of whom have become, you know, really good friends with you, and also the students. They will also miss you. So farewell, stay in touch, and best of luck. Bye, Lindsay.
A lot of you will know Sue Mabe, and some of you will have older brothers and sisters who know her too, because she's been here a very long time. She joined on the 15th of October 1996 and retires today after more than 23 years of extraordinary commitment to the school. During her time at Bedales, Sue has supported literally hundreds of students through the ups and downs of school life, teaching them and having faith in them when things were going well and also when they weren't. She is particularly good at spotting a student's strengths and talents and developing them, building their self-esteem and encouraging them to really investigate a subject in depth, particularly in literature, which is one of her passions. Another passion for Sue is her garden, which we are reminded about each autumn particularly, when she keeps her apple basket topped up with a variety of choices of apples as they ripen in turn and from which everyone helps themselves. Sue is generous with her time too. Over the years, she has offered her unfailing support to people throughout the Bedales community, both regularly and in times of particular crisis. I would like to say thank you to her on behalf of many students and staff for whom this support has been crucial. Another way in which Sue contributed to the Bedales community was through her picnic activity at lunchtime. This was not an official activity, but an example of Sue giving up her time to provide a regular opportunity each week for people to meet for a time of Christian-based reflection and spiritual refreshment. And it's been an important part of the school week for many people. Sue is retiring from teaching, and although we certainly say we hope she enjoys her retirement, being more at home, working in the garden, going on long walks, swimming and so on, I know that her terrific drive to help people in whatever way she can will soon see her involved in a variety of other things around Petersfield. Thank you, Sue, and please do come back and see us when you can.
It may come as a surprise to learn that Sarah Oakley is leaving the school after 18 years of committed and caring service to the school. She joined the school in 2002 and has served under three heads of department in that time, providing professionalism, wisdom, and stability. In this time, she has given her expertise tirelessly. This is a compliment all too often freely given, however, it is entirely appropriate in this case. Sarah has expended huge efforts in helping students develop their artistic prowess and, really importantly, helping them with their after Bedales plans. It is in her role within the professional guidance department that her knowledge, depth of understanding, careful attention to detail, and selflessness has come to the fore again. She is an enormously valued member of the team. Sarah is a caring and compassionate colleague. We're all very sad to see her go. We wish you all the very best, Sarah.
Peter Thackeray. Peter Thackeray has been at Bedales for 8 years. He joined Bedales in the autumn term of 2012, where he was appointed to the much sought after position of Head of Modern Languages, a position he held for 3 years. During that time, his patience, energy, and people-focused approach created a department of well-supported colleagues, where he rolled out the new GCSE syllabus, including Russian for the first time at Bedales. Peter's warmth and energy saw him recover from a first day campaign to have him removed from the school by heartbroken Block 4s, who were missing their beloved Tristan Wilson, who Peter had replaced. And from this brilliant start, Peter was able to slowly put languages on the map, getting permission to have Block 3 studying three languages in their timetable, and also seeing a huge uptake in the number of students studying languages at A-level. When Nick Shannon stepped down from Housemaster and Voice Flat, Peter was the obvious choice to replace him. And for the last 5 years, Peter has worked tirelessly to bring the same organised and calm environment he left on the second floor of the Orchard building to Flat. He's been a remarkable house parent, and more recently a head of boarding, guiding the school through its most recent compliance inspection, ensuring that all of the school's documentation and quality of boarding care are up to the highest standards. His devotion to the pupils in his care, their families, and the whole spectrum of the students' lives has meant he's had the busiest 5 years of his life. Becoming a parent to Balthazar 2 years ago hasn't blunted his edge. He's continued to support his colleagues throughout with the same level of attention and understanding, universally treating each person and every situation with empathy and consideration, always placing other interests before his own. The community has always come first. It was sadly no surprise to hear that he had been appointed to be Deputy Headmaster of Harrow School, Shanghai, this January, where he'll have the opportunity for a whole school to benefit from his benign and human-focused leadership. A new continent, a new school, a new set of challenges for Peter, his amazing wife Ellie and family to tackle. Peter, I'm going to miss you enormously, like everyone who's had the fortune to have been taught by you or supported by you over the last 8 years. Thank you for everything you've done here. Good luck on your new adventure. Respectfulness is important, Peter, so carry on getting it right. Thank you.
Elena joined us in 2002, and if my maths is correct, which it might not be, that's 18 years of service as Spanish language assistant. But Elena was always more than a Spanish assistant, with the amount of dedication and work that she put into her lessons that she put on for our GCSE Spanish students and our A-level Spanish students. Elena's one of those really warm characters, and her absence will be noticeable in the Orchard building. Elena also helped us out. She also went on the A-level trip to Bilbao last November, which shows an amazing commitment from an assistant. We wish Elena all the very best for her retirement.
As some of you know, Ben Shaw is leaving the school after 14 years of wholehearted service to the school. In his 14 years, he has contributed incredibly widely to the broader life and health of the school. In his time here, he has been a 6-2 house parent. He's led the design department, led three Swaziland trips, accompanied numerous Ulswater trips, run the D of V, and done lots of sports coaching. he's done other things as well. Ben gives his time freely to others and genuinely cares for the community and, importantly, those around it too. He leaves to fulfil a long-held ambition to return to Northern Scotland to pursue outdoor education and to continue his love of teaching design. It is with a heavy heart that many of us say goodbye to him. We wish you the very best, Ben.
Hello. I know that other colleagues have already spoken about the house parents that are leaving this term, but I just wanted to add a few thoughts from me. I work very closely with the house parents and I know how incredibly hard they work and how much they care for you and how much they do that you probably are not aware of behind the scenes. And I want to wish Alistair, Jill, Ben and Peter all the very best from me and also from you for their future plans. They've all got really exciting things that they can look forward to and I know that they'll miss you very, very much. And I personally would also miss working so closely with such a professional group of people. So thank you very much indeed for all that you've done for Bedales. And I hope you're looking forward to the future. We will miss you. Thank you.
Bedales is not merely a place where you spend some happy years, a place to which you now and then return. It is not merely a few years of life to be made the most of at the time and looked back on with pleasure. I would rather you came to think of it as a way of life, one that you need not leave behind, but one you can carry with you and live with anywhere as well as here.
At the close of another term, we are thankful for all the opportunities and enjoyment of these weeks past.
Let the lessons of this term deepen within our hearts, that it may be bearing more and more fruit in our lives.
We wish well on all of those who are going forth from our midst to face the battle of life.
And we wish for all those who remain that they make Bedales all that it can be.
Let us act in such a way that when our time comes to leave,
we may look back with thankfulness upon all the days here.
We come together with hearts full of thankfulness for all this term has brought us, both gladness and effort and strength. And in all humility, acknowledge our shortcomings and failures.
Let us use the lessons of this term. Let us pass that we might go forward more bravely to what is to come.
So as we come to the end of this assembly, no leave-taking assembly would be complete without some words from the chief, who's on my wall looking benignly over everything I do and probably looking out onto the orchard wondering why everything is so quiet and empty at the end of the summer term when normally there's an energetic and excited bustle about things as you break up for the summer holiday. So just to quote from one of his Sunday evening talks, this is him speaking about the idea of a Bedales education. And that is to me the true object of education, he writes. If you think of education as something more than merely the giving of instruction, instruction is to give us knowledge and skill, tools which we can use for any purpose, good or bad. But education is to show for what purposes we may best use them, to set not only before our eyes, but in our hearts, visions of what may be, not as remote ideals merely, but as things realizable in an actual world, if we will help to make them so. I hope that you carry with you the remembrance of what life can be made. And most of all, I hope you carry with you some vision of what you want to make it, a sense of values to set before your purposes towards which to press, and a faith, not necessarily a religious faith, and a faith to sustain you, whatever life may bring. So well done, 6-2, for all your efforts and everything you've contributed to the Bedales community in your time here. And well done, everyone, for getting through such a difficult and challenging term and achieving so much along the way. I really look forward to seeing everyone, bar 6-2, back in September. That would be a surprise. But of course, we will make sure that we carve out some proper time
for a full farewell to this year's 6-2 Leavers. So meanwhile, I really hope that you enjoy your summer holiday. Thank you very much to the staff for all they've done to support you during this strange term. I hope that you have some time to rest and recuperate, and I look forward to seeing you all in the flesh in September. Okay, well done everyone, and goodbye.
Goodbye, farewell. Thank you for all your hard work throughout this year. I'm really, really proud about the way that everybody's pulled together. I'm so looking forward to seeing you all again in person soon. Take care.
Thanks for everything you've done to make this community a better place, either before or after lockdown. You should be really proud of what you've achieved, and have a great summer.
Bedalians, I hope you have a really great summer, and I hope that when you come back, you have faces. I haven't seen an authentic Bedalian face in weeks, apart from Ewan's. So looking forward to seeing your faces in September.
We wish you all the best for the future.
And we really look forward to seeing you on the team chat for our final assembly
at 12 o'clock.
Everybody, have a great summer, and especially good luck to those 6-2 who are leaving. Sorry it's had to end this way, and best of luck to everybody coming back next year. Bye.
Good night, au revoir, bonne soirée, до свидания, до встречи. Have a great summer. Well done. Good night.
It was never supposed to end like this.
Say, Forrest, look, there you are. There you are. When you were in block 3 and block 4, there's me standing behind Keith. Well done. It's been such a hard year and you've done a great job. I will miss you so much. I'm looking forward to catching up with you at a rock show sometime in the future. So have a great summer. Try not to cry too much and hopefully I will see you soon.
Have a great summer. Bye-bye.
Hi. The sun's shining outside and summer is here at last. It's been a challenging year, but well done for everything you've done to help keep our community going and keep us all working together. Have a brilliant summer. Hopefully we'll see you after the holidays, but if you're moving on to something else, I wish you every luck for the future.
Hi everybody, have a lovely summer. This is Lily. She and all the other animals have missed you, so hope you have a lovely summer and that we see you all back soon. And those of you who are leaving, all the very best. Put the right foot forward.
Goodbye 6-2, it has been a wonderful year spending time with you on 6-2 Flat. You have made this year a real pleasure to work and I will miss you. All the best, every one of you, for the future.
Goodbye everybody, hope you have a lovely summer, you deserve it. Take care.
I'm really sorry that we don't get to say goodbye properly in handshaking, but I really hope you have a great summer. And that you have a good rest and you come back prepared for a fantastic year next year. I can't wait to see everybody back in the quad, getting to say hello properly and getting to say goodbye properly and doing proper handshakings and getting back to normal. Bedales has been great in isolation because we've stuck together fantastically as a community, but I really, really can't wait to be back with you all in person. So have a great summer and see you next year. Goodbye.
Those of you moving on at the end of this year, very heartfelt goodbye from me to you. So many happy memories, and I'm sorry we're not doing it in person. And then for those of you I'm going to see in September, really looking forward to that. Have a very restful summer.
Hi there. For 6-2, I know this is goodbye, but I do look forward to seeing you in the near future. For the rest of the student body, I hope you have a relaxing summer break and get away from all your computers. And I look forward to seeing you in September.
Goodbye and good luck to all the leavers. You'll all be very much missed. A very special mention must go to my 6-2 netballers. We only had half a season, which is a shame, but what a season it was. Very proud of you all and wish you all the best luck for the future. Bye.
Good luck with everything. Sorry the way the year ended, but we look forward to welcoming you back to Bedales at some point in the future to say goodbye to you all properly. Good luck with everything.
It's been an absolute pleasure working with you. Some of you I've taught dance from block 3, some of you I've been tutoring in block 4 and 5. Have a great summer holiday and I wish you all the best for the future.
Well, here we are, end of term. Have a very happy summer, everyone. Make it a refreshing and relaxing one. And well done to all my students for coping so well with this strange world that we have lived in. I'm looking forward to seeing you properly in September.
Bye everyone, and best of luck. Sorry we couldn't say goodbye in person, but hopefully we'll be able to catch up in September. Special mention to my 6-2 chemists. Molecules have to be covalently bonded. Please don't ever forget that. Bye.
Hi there. In the absence of being able to say goodbye to you in person, just wanted to say goodbye. Good luck to all of 6-2, Block 5, and anyone else who has the misfortune to be leaving the school in these sad times. It's a shame we can't say goodbye in person, but good luck to you all. And please come back and say hello at the earliest opportunity. Good luck. Goodbye.
Got to do a virtual goodbye. Are you good at this sort of thing? Take care, everyone. You're absolutely smashing, wonderful bunch of people that I've got to know over the last couple of years. I'm sure we're going to meet up again soon. Look after yourselves.
Bye, everyone. Bye, 6-2s. Bye, Block 5s who are leaving us. Fingers crossed we'll get together very soon for a proper farewell. And to everyone else, have a really restful summer holidays and look forward to seeing you in person again very soon.
You've been incredible to teach during this year and also direct. Thank you for all of your hard work. Wishing you the very best for your futures. Bye.
Well done for getting through the year. Congratulations. Don't be a stranger and see you soon.
Well done on all your efforts this year. Getting through this difficult time. Have a great summer and I'll see everybody back in the September, hopefully.
Hello, everybody. I'm in a beautiful garden and I'm listening to some wonderful reggae, and I wanted to share a quote from Oscar Wilde to say goodbye. This is for everyone who I taught the importance of being earnest. And the quote is this: the truth is rarely pure and never simple. So remember that.
I'm so sad we can't have a proper hug and a proper goodbye, but a big virtual hug from me. And we're going to miss you so much. Really, really good luck for everything you do, and come back and visit us and have a great summer. Take care. Bye bye.
Have a great holiday. Bye.
Bye everybody. You're all amazing and I can't wait to see you again in September. A special goodbye to the 6-2 geographers. Been on a bit of a roller coaster, but we got there in the end. Bye for now, everybody.
Bye everyone. Have a fantastic holiday. Sure you all deserve it. I hope the weather's good. I hope you all get to do all those multitude of things that you'd like to do. 6-2, I wish you all the very best. I think you've been an absolutely fantastic year. Certainly I've enjoyed teaching the 6-2s that I've had in French, and I've enjoyed meeting all the other 6-2s on flat. Have a wonderful future and make the most of all those opportunities. Goodbye.
Goodbye, 6-2s of 2020. I'll miss you all so much. It's been absolutely wonderful getting to know you all, and I just wish you the very best with whatever the future holds. Just grab every opportunity and come back and tell us your amazing adventures.
Bonjour. Thank you so much, guys, for this year. You've been amazing. Have a great summer. Aux élèves de terminale, bonne chance pour la suite et merci pour tout. Au revoir.
I can't actually put into words how much I am going to miss you, your joy, your energy, your enthusiasm, and the continuous education you've given me on grime.
Goodbye, good luck, have a wonderful summer, and I hope to see you soon.
Well done on all you've achieved this year, on all your hard work. Have a great summer and look forward to seeing you in the not too distant future.
Goodbye and good luck to anybody that's leaving us today. Thank you so much for all those happy, wonderful memories that you've given me, be it in the DCR, Steephurst, the art department. It's a cliche, but that's... they're the bits that have really kind of make the job worthwhile and what I enjoy doing. So thank you very much. Do keep in touch and I hope to see you again soon. For everybody else, have a great restful summer and I look forward to seeing you in September.
Bye, have a nice summer. I look forward to seeing you back at Bedales in September.
What a year. Have a great summer.
Goodbye to those of you who are leaving us.
Good luck. So sorry we can't say goodbye as we normally would. And for those of you coming back in September, can't wait to see you.
Hi. Just wanted to say well done for everything you've achieved at your time here at Bedales, and good luck with whatever you go on to do. Have a great summer. Bye.
I've really enjoyed getting to know all of you in drama lessons, in tutor groups, in rehearsals, in performances, or just seeing you around the school. And I wish you the very, very best in everything you do from here on.
I'm really sorry not to see you all in person to say goodbye, but I hope you all have a fantastic summer and look forward to seeing you all again soon.
Well done. Have a great summer. Keep active.
Goodbye and good luck. Make the most of every opportunity you're going to be given in the future, and come back and see us again sometime soon.
Well, good luck, goodbye, and thanks to all the music scholars for their incredible help this year. Take care.
Many of you have waited a long time for this. Cheers.
This is goodbye then. It's going to be goodbye from me. It's goodbye from him. And good luck wherever life may lead you.
That's goodbye from me. Thanks so much to all of you who've made Bedales so special this year. All you guys who are leaving, you bring so much to the school, so much individuality, and so much creativity and music. Thank you to those musicians who've inspired us, and thank you to those guys who've clapped and supported. Have a great summer and keep in touch. We'll miss you. Bye.
Hello, everybody. Didn't teach very many of you, but if I did, or if I sang with you, or if I came into contact with you in other school activities, I wish you the very best of luck. I hope you have a really great time in whatever you're going to be doing next year.
To my drama guys, you know who you are. We've been on a journey together, and I'm just so sorry that this is how we have to say goodbye. Keep smiling, be brave, and I can't wait to hear where life takes you. A really fond farewell from me.
Just tell me what's missing.